We have with us now the esteemed Bishop Singleton.
My name is Alfred Singleton. I was born October the 18th, 1928, in Montgomery, Alabama.
Bishop Alfred Singleton is a third oldest son of seven children. He come from a family of preachers. Great-grandfather, great-uncle was the presiding elder in the Methodist Church.
Grandfather.
I was grandfather, and someone says great-uncle, so well, great-grandfather was a presiding elder in the Methodist Church. And Bishop Singleton was a member at one time of the Methodist Church as well. He also had training in the Catholic Church, and he's a Southern preacher.
I remember when I was a little boy coming up, I used to preach on the chair. And I remember as a little tot fella that I was taken away. It looked like the Lord God took me away, way away someplace, and it dealt with me. But I can't just, and every once in a while that come back to me. So that's something, that's a phenomenon about life. You know, you learn as you go on and things begin to unfold to you. And when I was around about 10 years old, my daddy, because I should live with him some, as I said, he said to me once, and he heard me, he said, I was talking so loud, he said, boy, you must gonna be a preacher. So, so he lived long enough to see me to be a preacher.
Bishop was to tell you, he said God dealt with him while he was in the Army 2 years after he left Detroit, after he had received the Holy Ghost. And in his own words, he said, this happening was a mystery. I told him, Lord, if you want me to preach, knowing my inability to preach, you will have to let me know, and someone else too.
Made the unsaved man on the base that I was a military man. I went home and a sister confronted me, a nice evangelist, spiritual minded. She said, God have called you to preach. I can see it. I said, sister, you pray for me. I just kept walking. I didn't want to give my hand to no one. I wanted God to do it. He gave me a spiritual song. When he got through, he began to speak through me like I was speaking in tongues. He took my voice, my ordered voice, and told me, I have called you to preach. I've called you to preach. I couldn't stop. Just like I was speaking in tongues. He said, now you told me to make you know it and somebody else. So I had the unsaved man on the base to tell you. I had the sister at the church to tell you. He said, now I'm telling you.
See, but only when that which is driven by God, that's the thing that is going to last. We brought nothing into this world. We really don't own anything. And I use the term, we have arrived. Well, I have arrived, and that's why I'm telling this story. Because the time is for that, to do that. But along the way, you can't tell the story until you arrive.
I am one of the senior bishops of the PCFAF. I've been in the organization since its inception, and of course I'm the one that decided about this great Golden Award dinner. And I thought it too long we leave the good deeds of others to cast their fragrance as roses long after they're gone.
Absolutely.
But I thought that shouldn't be true. And so we decided we will have something for everybody. And we set anyone who had a tenure of 15 years, that was the minimum. And from the bishop board to the maintenance man, then making a difference who it is. So we're trying to recognize everybody.
There's a passage in the Bible, the steps of a good man is ordered by the Lord. So God directed my path.
I don't believe I'm here by accident.
My
father, when I was a little boy, he started me out at the Catholic school. Paid for it, he had a good job. And his plan was from there to college, to university. But God changed everything. My grandfather and his uncles was preachers. Now, if I had went that way, I probably would have been a preacher. but not the preacher that God wanted me to be.
All right.
So God moves in what? Mysterious. And because I'm a holy, sanctified, holy, roller preacher,
amen,
and just got sense enough to be a country preacher, I'm able to help somebody and tell everybody I know somebody can save anybody.
Amen.
And he saved my life, and I could have been killed as a little boy. I never forget one day of my friend and I, a young boy and I, a friend, we were just little young, little tots. And we were going, we had to go under the boxcar, and we had a pail. And I had a pail in my hand, we tried to go and get some water, bang, bang. And when I got under the boxcar, and the train pulled off, and bent the pail that I had, and God had the switchman there to give an emergency stop thing. That's what saved me. So these are the things that God helped me with. So he wouldn't let me get killed because he knew what he wanted me to be.
Something about the goodness of the Lord. If I didn't have a pulpit, my God, I'll go out into the interior and cut a stump. And me and Jesus will have a thing going. The birds will have to hear me. My God, the snakes will have to hear me. I will tell the story of Jesus. God bless y'all. I said enough.